Ladies, it's your time to shine with all things fabulous with First for Women on Afternoon Express. For insurance with a host of fabulous benefits, call 0861 11 1844 or SMS FIRST to 49267.
Today on Afternoon Express, the gorgeous Boity Thulo joins us on our couch. We catch up with SAMA award-winning singer Simphiwe Dana. Model and blogger Emma Jane Menteath shares some terrific travel tips for women. We have a look at the hottest in repurposed goods with Katie Thompson. Learn all about mini herb gardens with landscape artist Cheral Kennedy. And in the kitchen, it's all about tomatoes.
Good afternoon and a very warm welcome to Afternoon Express. It's 1 hour a day where you get to indulge in all things fabulous with myself, Jeannie D.
I'm Bonang Whatever.
And I'm Bonnie Mbue. And of course, it's all about expression and we do it inspirationally all to entertain you. I love this razzle dazzle.
Yeah. It is Tuesday, which for me means specifically Tuesday. And ladies, there is huge coveting going on in this room today. Bonang Whatever, as much as I love you, you're not going home with those babies today because those puppies are finding their way into my wardrobe.
I know where to find you.
Also, it's no secret that my greatest passion in life is travel. So today we've got the gorgeous blogger Emma Menteath from Our Life in Pink in studio who's going to be giving us some awesome travel tips.
Looking forward to that. But before Bonnie and I tell you exactly who else is in the loft today, just a reminder to make sure that you interact with us on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, and use our official handle at Afternoon Chat and our official hashtag, hashtag Afternoon Express. But let's move on,
let's find out who's in the loft
to the
today.
Rest of the loft and tell you who exactly we're going to be chilling with today.
Miss Simphiwe Dana.
Seven-time SAMA winning songstress Simphiwe Dana is in studio. She's going to be performing, plus we're going to be chatting to her. She's been dubbed the new Miriam Makeba.
Oh, wow. What an honor.
I know, right? Ready to tickle her mind. Also, sexy, sexy Boity Thulo is here, so don't move.
Me find out what's cooking in the kitchen. Anda Dlepu joining us today.
Good afternoon, afternoon.
And it's all things Italian trending in the kitchen today.
Yes, that's correct.
We're making a multi-purpose tomato sauce.
That's correct.
Along with a caprese salad.
Yes,
accompanied by my favorite herb, basil.
So the tomato sauce I'm going to be making for you today isn't your regular smooth store-bought tomato sauce. It's going to be a bit chunky, so it's great to go for your pasta. It's great to have as a dipping sauce on the side, or if you'd like it to have it as an accompaniment for something else, it's great as well.
Thank you, Anda. That sounds great. In the meantime, pop over to our website, www.afternoonexpress.co.za, to find out the full recipe and list of ingredients so that you can cook along with us. So while you do that, let's take a break and join us afterwards when we speak to one of the sexiest women in South Africa, Miss Boity Thulo. Don't go away.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express on 3. Now, her big break came in 2010 when she appeared as the sweet face on a TV commercial. Yeah. Since then, she has been heating up our screens and known for her curvaceous booty and sensational smile. In fact, in some parts, I think her booty is more famous than the smile. And she has just arrived at our apartment and our gorgeous butler's just letting her in. Mm-hmm. Please welcome the sensational Boity Thulo. Hello, she has arrived.
I'm staying with Valentine.
Yeah.
I know, right? So he might be incredibly desirable, but madam, you are one of the most desirable women in the country.
Oh, please, how do you think Jeannie D. Are you joking? You should be the last person talking about that.
How are you? Are you well? I want to know everything that's happening in your life.
Well, I'm actually at the moment not that busy. Like, I just got Club 808, which is fantastic.
Yeah.
I'm so happy. It's great to start presenting again.
But it's awesome.
Like a, yeah, I feel like it's a great platform to get back into my presenting. Because I had let it go a bit and tried to concentrate on the acting.
It's so interesting how we're both there.
Yeah.
Because the last time we were on set together, I was your mother.
Yes, you were.
No.
And now we're here as sisters.
Shut the front door.
No.
I was. So
she was like the sexiest mom anyone had ever seen.
I was a MILF.
You were.
That
you
was definitely a teen pregnancy if ever I've seen one. Yeah. You find that when people are in conversation with you, they have to resist every urge to mention your derriere.
Yeah. I'm so
it's hard not to.
Yeah, please. I'm so Ray Charles right now because I think it's like it happened and now it's over, let's move on. Yeah, it's kind of like sometimes very weird for people to want to talk about that all the time. It's just a bump. Let's move on. You have one, I have one, you have one. Come on.
I sometimes don't have one. I've got to squat
squats,
a lot
girl.
More.
Squats. That's the
you
only way.
You will be my aspiration.
Yeah. Don't mind.
Tell me, are you single at the moment?
I am single. I am happily single. It's
what, what do you feel about dating, though?
I think I've reached a point in my life and my age where... where it's okay for it to be serious and for you to want it to be the one. And the I think personally I've passed the stage of let's try it out, let's see how it works. Like, yeah. I mean, I know people would be like, oh, you're too young to settle, but I mean, like, every try that I, you know, every person that I try out should be for the be all and end all. Should
exactly.
be for the last go. I think, yeah, the whole dating scene is... I'm not doing it that often because I'm just like, I don't think the people in my age group and the people I'm kind of attracted to are there yet
to
settle down. So
yeah.
I'm just taking it easy.
But it's good to just focus on your career until
Absolutely.
Such time.
Absolutely. And I think always the universe, you know, it brings you the right
What you
things.
Need when you need
yeah,
it.
Yeah, when you need it. You know, and when the student is ready, the teacher appears.
Right.
So that's how it works.
You've always been so wise, boy. It's wise beyond your years.
God, you really are.
There's a thing the media loves to do, and they love to ascribe this title to young female entertainers, and it's called the it girl, right?
Yeah. Mm.
And by virtue of them saying it girl, they're saying there can only be one at any given time.
Mm-hmm. I'm so over that.
There's
so many. That makes women compete with each other.
Exactly.
It's very unfair living.
So I want to ask, it perpetuates this unhealthy competition amongst females and people aren't supporting each other in a country that's already, I mean, it's a rough industry.
Yeah,
you
exactly.
need a thick
very
skin.
Very small as well.
How do you deal with that pressure of not succumbing to that it girl race?
It doesn't concern me what people say, what they think, and the pressure just diminishes and it disappears because you end up realizing that you're here for, the journey is so much bigger than just a career. You know,
I
so
love
yeah.
your hair. Yeah. What brought on that change? Big change.
Yeah, it was a huge
what
change.
What brought it on? Because I know when a woman changes her hair, it's usually because something is shifting in her life. There's a paradigm shift.
Yeah, I actually found that out after I changed my hair and I was like, well, maybe. Actually, because the day I decided to change my hair, I think it was closer to the time when I realized that I needed I had a spiritual blockage. So I was trying every little thing that I felt like would make me feel like I'm in control. Mm. You know, yeah. So when I decided to cut my hair, I was like, you know what, I'm gonna cut my hair. And I felt like it was going to bring me closer to feeling like I'm in control of me. So I did it and I cut my hair and I changed it and it felt fantastic actually. Yeah.
You are such an inspirational woman. I mean, you're such a beauty, but also, and you've really got your life together.
Well,
and you've got a very beautiful perception on how you view things and how you take things.
Thank
I wish you the best of luck in your career.
Thank you
you really
much.
Do deserve so much success.
The apple didn't fall far from the tree.
apparently were an amazing
She's
mother.
She's incredible. She's like...
From these saucy starlets, we've got a sauce of a different kind in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Let's hook up with Bonang to see how she's doing.
Indeed, Jeannie, and today we're making an all-purpose tomato sauce right here in the kitchen, standing by with Woolworths food developer Anda. Lovely to have you. For anybody that missed the beginning of the show, why do we call this an all-purpose tomato sauce?
So I've called it an all-purpose tomato sauce because it's quite a versatile tomato sauce.
Okay.
It's not your store-bought tomato sauce, which is smooth, and so it's quite chunky. It's great with pasta, it's great with the sauce, it's great on tacos. So let's get it started.
Let's get this started.
So I've got oil, I've added our Mediterranean oil inside here, and now I'm just going to add the onions which are chopped.
Right. And is that just one onion?
That's just one onion, yes,
all
but
right.
just finely chopped. The finer it's chopped, the quicker the process will be as well.
Great
So
tip.
I've got other veggie. I've got carrots and celery here with a bit of garlic as well. So this is what we call the mirepoix. This is the basic stick, the beginning of any sauce.
Okay.
We can add the garlic actually now as
all
well.
All of it?
Yeah, we can
I
add all of it.
I love garlic.
Yes.
Garlic is good.
So the plan would be to soften this first, so to just cook it for a while and just to get it softened first.
And then how do you know that the onions are ready?
When we see the onions are ready, you'll see the onions will go translucent, which is quite a sign for us too, that we can actually throw the veg in then at the time. So let me just
You're making me work here, hey?
So let me just throw the veg in.
Uh-huh.
The celery and the carrots. I'm not going to throw all of them in.
How much celery, how much carrots?
Just equal parts carrots to celery, but you would like definitely, so equal parts onions, carrots, and celery. You wouldn't want too much of one.
Okay.
Let's get this started for our caprese salad. So we've got so we've got vine tomatoes here on the vine. So quite simply, all we're going to do is just put that on the tray. We've got our salt, we've got our pepper.
All right.
You could add some salt there for me, please.
All right,
and I've got
just
some pepper as well.
Right, okay.
Then again, the Mediterranean oil, which I'm going to be using for this. We've got our Italian olive oil, which is great, but just going for the Mediterranean one this time. Mm-hmm. So just a little bit light drizzle there, drizzle. And we can put that in the oven. Just shake it around a little bit.
Shake this around.
Yes.
And then, Anda, how do you know that the, you know, the tomatoes are ready?
The tomatoes, you'll see that the skin starts to burst out and the juice of the tomato wants to come out.
All
so
right.
We can just pop that straight in the oven
working
while I just watch this quick.
Working to the oven.
Thank you.
Working so hard.
Yes,
there we go.
All right,
what's next?
See, once the veg is soft, we can add our Italian tinned tomatoes. So this product, a very iconic product to us at Woolies. I'm going to put the tomatoes in whole.
All right.
And the cooking process will kind of get the tomatoes to get
crushed.
How
many cans? Two?
I'm going to be using two cans here because my veg is allowing for me to do that.
That already smells divine.
So our Italian tomatoes, great story. The quality of this, these tomatoes come straight from Italy. And
wow.
We go each year with our suppliers in September to go pick the variety which we want.
Wow.
Out of 320 different varieties, this is the variety which has been selected for this season.
Okay.
So these tomatoes are sun-ripened tomatoes, which are baked by the Mediterranean sun during the Italian summer. Oopsie. So let's let that cook just for a couple of minutes, just 10 minutes or so, just to let the tomatoes actually get the juice out and to get the veg to kind of melt down with the tomatoes. So let's just
Fantastic.
Let that cook down for a little bit.
All right, and then we'll move on to part two a little
bit
later
we'll
in
back
the show.
To that again,
All right, Anda, thank you very much. Some education throwing it in there as well. Woolworths food developer right here on Afternoon Express. Do not forget the ingredients and, of course, the recipe you can find on our website, www.afternoonexpress.co.za. After the break, we chat to a woman who's been hailed as a new Miriam Makeba, 7 psalmists underneath her belt. Her name is Simphiwe Dana. Don't move. We're going to be chatting to her. See you after the break. Welcome back to Afternoon Express on SABC3. We're still chilling with the sexy Boity Thulo, right here in studio. Don't forget to keep all your messages coming through Twitter and Facebook. We do love hearing from you. But our next guest is a lady that has been hailed as a brand new Miriam Makeba. She's got 7 SAMA awards under her belt, and she's absolutely amazing. She's celebrating 10 years in the music industry in 2015. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome in the loft, Miss Simphiwe Dana. Yes!
Amazing!
Zan, zan, zan!
Oh,
the queen!
Hello, hi, ladies.
So lovely to see you.
It's lovely to be here.
Wow.
Thank you.
Finally.
You know what? I was busy. I was walking behind you when you actually came in, and the security guard checked you out, and then he looked at his friend. He was like, Diana Ross. I was like, no.
I think you went too far.
But
you went way too far.
Gina, you should have seen it at the South African Music Awards. Simphiwe was performing with Kurt on stage. It was bigger than what it is right now. Absolutely incredible.
Now, I don't know what shocked people more, your hair at the summers or the fact that you were performing in Afrikaans. Take me through that performance. How did that come about?
For me, I was petrified completely. I was so worried about that performance. I think even 2 minutes before I was supposed to get on stage, I was checking my lines that I won't mess anything up because I don't speak Afrikaans.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't speak it at all.
You know, but I thought it's a really nice challenge. Yeah. You know, a beautiful song from Kurt and lovely person Kurt is.
Yeah.
And
is
our voices complement each other so well. I thought, why not? Let's do it. And it went so well, and we had such a lovely time doing it. I can imagine that in the future we'll do more.
Absolutely. But this is something that you're so good at doing, and this is why 10 years later in your career, you are still doing so well, because you were able to reinvent yourself over and over again. What's been your strength, do you think, to be able to just bounce back all the time?
Well, I mean, you know, it's not even like a conscious thing where I decide, okay, I'm going to reinvent myself. I just allow the growth process, you know. I grow, and I allow the growth. If now I feel something needs to change in my life, I'm getting bored, you know, and then I check myself, well, what do I want to do? And then I just do it, you know. So I don't create prisons for myself, you know, character prisons or whatever sort of prisons. You know, I grow. And I allow the growth, and I'm very honest with myself, with, you know, whatever I want to do, I go
But let's talk about your brand new album. You know, for me, it's always interesting when I sit down with artists or designers or, you know, TV hosts, actresses, what their creative process is. What is your creative process when you sit down and say, I'm putting together a song, or I'm deciding who I'm collaborating with, or I'm deciding on a look or a hair or a, you know, an evolution of brands in Simphiwe Dana?
I'm a very spontaneous person. And I don't have a single album where I've sat down and said, okay, this is how I want to do this album. The creative process happens spontaneously. And then it's up to me to go through it or not. So I don't really have like a plan. Like, I want to do this.
Okay.
And I mean, it's not necessarily a good way to live. You know, to
live spontaneously. I think it is with external inspiration.
I think the only way is to live spontaneously.
I think so too, to be quite honest.
Really?
I can't plan. I'm not a planner. I'm one day to the next. I would love to plan.
I'm just not a planner. Yeah. I just allow life to happen through me.
Yeah. You have a creative process in terms of, you know, acting.
I completely agree with her. Yeah. Well, I think I just allow things to happen naturally.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that's the safest way, because then nothing is forced.
But Simphiwe, we have two little children.
Yes.
Have they started, you know, following in mom's steps, music?
Art. Well, my daughter is quite the artist and quite the writer as well.
Wow.
She's like a little, very intelligent bunch of energy. She's my mom, actually. It's the other way.
Okay.
And my son, on the other hand, he loves to play a lot.
Okay.
A lot. And he's very good with maths for some very strange reason, because I'm like, but you're always playing. When do you get time to get A's in maths? You know? Okay. But I like the fact that my kids don't look like they'll be following in my footsteps.
Where do you think they're headed?
Well, I think Zazie wants to be a president. The way she's like very serious.
That's dumb.
And my son, I think actually my son might still end in the creative industry, because he loves the camera. He loves the camera, and he loves to act up for people. When there are people around, then, you know, he wants to put on a show.
I love that. Okay, fantastic.
Now, you've both traveled a fair deal, and I mean, obviously with your performing as well. Where's been the best place that you've been received across the world?
I mean, there was a time I traveled Europe extensively. And it was amazing. Germany received me really well. Italy, Spain, the UK as well, and then the US. And then I was also in Senegal, I was received really well, and Kenya.
Amazing.
Wow. I'm in Nigeria.
Everyone in the world just loves you. Everyone just love you. And you, B, you're a New York girl.
Oh,
you
my goodness.
You live for Central Park.
I would. If I had packed all my bags that one time I went to New York, I would have never come back, honestly.
I'm not sure if you want to stay in New York or just visit. Because the cost of living there is very
high.
Well, if we ignore that.
But today is Travel Tuesday, so if you ladies will please excuse me. Now, traveling obviously is one of the greatest things in my life, but the packing, not so much. It almost spoils the game. But if you know how to do it properly, well, then the rest is all smooth sailing. Here we've got Bonnie and, of course, blogger from My Life in Pink, teaching us how to pack properly. Emma Menteath, welcome to loft here on Afternoon Express. And I can see you're already half packed.
Yeah. Yeah, we kind of started, got it going.
Can I just jump the gun and say, I'm so excited to know how to pack my jewelry. I've got the daintiest pendants. And by the time I get to my destination, they're all tangled up and I'm sitting there with the pin, like.
Yep, I'm exactly the same.
Jewelry's the worst to pack.
So I've planned a couple of some of my favorite packing tips, because over the past couple of years, I've definitely learned the best ways to pack.
And you're only 22, by the way, so.
Well, 23 now.
Wow.
But anyway.
Wow.
No, I've been fortunate enough with the blogging and with modeling to be able to travel.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. No, in the beginning I used to pack everything except the kitchen sink, but now it's I've got
minimalist. Yeah. Okay, so give us some tips, and I think the jewellery one is a good one to start off with.
Okay, cool.
Because we both definitely unpick our chains a lot.
So, well, this works best for dainty jewellery. You basically lay a piece of cling wrap down, place your dainty jewellery on the cling wrap, and then place another piece of cling wrap over it. And this way you've got your jewellery set in the cling wrap.
Fabulous.
And you just lay it at the bottom of your luggage and place your clothing over it. Another tip is shower caps that you get from hotels to keep them and to place your shoes inside of them.
Oh, wow.
This way you don't get the dirt on your shoes.
And if you're like Jeannie, you need about 20 shower caps.
I've noticed that you've got a hairdryer, but now don't all hotels have hairdryers?
Yes, that's why I have the hairdryer. So when we travel, we don't travel with our irons, obviously. A lot of the hotels don't often have, well, they'll have an ironing service, but you know, sometimes if you're young and you can't afford it, or if you're staying in some student housing and there's no iron.
Or it takes about 2 hours to actually get the ironing.
That as well. Or sometimes you're terrible at ironing. These tips have really like worked for me. And one of them is if you've got blazers or jackets that crease, you just turn them inside out. And then you fold them and then you pack them inside your luggage. And the turning them inside out just helps create less creases. Otherwise, besides that, if you place your clothing inside a dry cleaning bag before you pack and then you fold it, this also creates less creases.
Wow. Amazing.
I'm not exactly sure why,
flick out and then wear the minute you land.
No, it just works. And if that still doesn't work, and you still end up having creases all over your clothing, we all know that somewhere there's going to be a trusty hairdryer. Either one of the ladies in the where you're staying will have one, or the hotel will have one. So you just hang your clothes up and spritz a little bit of water from the basin, just spritz it on and take your hair dryer and use the heat to...
That is so clever. I'm actually just going to do that at home on the daily.
Do you know what I have done before, actually? I had to present the red carpet at the Emmys and I had this beautiful silk dress. And as I pulled it out, I thought, oh my goodness, this dress is so creased. So what I did was I hung it up in the shower in my bathroom and put the hot water on that I steamed the entire
bathroom. That's really smart, actually.
And steamed the dress.
Yeah.
It made my hair frizz as well. So that wasn't the best idea. These are just really nice shoes.
They're gorgeous.
Get back in the bag. I want to pack them in my bag.
What size are they?
Tuesday. They're my size. Perfect. Yeah. Okay, what have we got here?
So this is one that I actually learned from primary school when my mom used to pack little juices for me in my bag.
Ah.
She used to, before she used to close the lid on the juice, she would put a piece of plastic down, tighten the lid, and that way my juice wouldn't spill in my bag at school.
Oh, wow.
And I found that it worked perfect for while I was traveling as well, because I would arrive in London or New York and I would have cream or shampoo all over my bag.
Oh yes, that's happened to
and
me.
That's an absolute nightmare because then I don't have shampoo to wash my hair or...
And you have to wash your clothes and it's a mess.
So this is honestly one of my favorite tricks. Besides that, this is also another great one. I learned this from a makeup artist from London who traveled down here. She places cotton pads in all her compacts.
To stop her powder from cracking. Yes. Do you know how much money I've wasted cracking all my makeup powder?
So this is a pretty handy one that I really do enjoy and I use for all my makeup tips and tricks.
I'm loving how I can use some of these tips now already.
Exactly.
Yeah. This is my absolute favorite. Like, this is my must for traveling. And it's having one of these mini little scales in your bag for when you travel. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because I go over...
That's danger zone for me.
I go over with like 20 or 30 kilograms in my bag and I come back with 100 kilograms.
Wow.
So the night before I need to figure out how to pack.
Yes.
So I don't arrive at the airport with too much weight. And so this honestly is one of the handiest things. It comes with me everywhere when I travel. Besides that, another good packing trick is your shoes.
Mm-hmm.
To stuff them with socks, underwear, or even toiletries that don't fit in your toiletry bags. This way you also save more space.
Yes.
And perfect, yeah. A lot of us travel with a lot of technology. iPad cables, iPhone cables, earphones.
Too much, actually.
So to use your old sunglasses cases to store cables inside of.
Oh, wow. You asked me, where have you been all my life? Yeah. I've been traveling nonstop for the past 11 years. And I'm going, oh, that's a really good idea. Why did nobody tell me that? So obviously, for more of these tips, people can visit your blog.
Yes, yeah. Mylifeinpink.co.za.
Thank you, Emma.
Thank you.
There you go. Handy tips
for stress-free traveling. And of course, all that information can be found on our website, www.afternoonexpress.co.za.
Don't go away. After the break, we take old furniture and turn it from drab to fab with upcycling and a performance by the sensational Simphiwe Dana.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express on SABC3. Self-proclaimed hoarder and lover of junk, Katie Thompson is here to share with us her inspiration and some of her most beautiful objects. Welcome to the show, Katie. It's lovely to have you.
Lovely to have you. Nice to see you. Now, you own a shop called Recreate in Cape Town, which is an upcycler's dream. For anybody that's watching right now, what is upcycling?
Upcycling is one step ahead of recycling. Ah. And it's taking an object and giving it a new life, and instead of breaking it down as you do with recycling, so recycling, for example, if you were to recycle a Coke bottle, you would break it down into its former components and make it into something new. Whereas upcycling, you don't break it down as such.
You take it up, darling.
Is this a word
that's known, or is it something you've coined?
No. It is a known word.
My bad. All right. But Katie, where did you get the idea, you know, to repurpose secondhand objects? When did you fall in love with recreating and upgrading old, you know, furniture and things?
I've always been a hoarder,
and you turned your hobby into, you know, a business, a thriving business.
Yeah, I have a background in interior design, and I think it really all stems from there.
Can you show us some of your beautiful objects?
Varna.
That is really fantastic. Thank you so much, Varna. Now, I mean, Katie, this is fantastic. From just looking at it, it looks like a briefcase, a suitcase, correct?
That's right.
All right. So take us through it. How did you create this beautiful chair?
So this is one of our first pieces about 6 years ago when I started Recreate. And it's a vintage suitcase, and the idea is when you can no longer use them to travel with, and they were going to just either end up sitting in your garage or end up on a landfill, we make them into functional seating pieces.
And obviously you'd sell this then in the store.
Absolutely.
Yeah. All right.
You can sit on them, they're functional seating items.
How long would it take to make something like that?
I always give the lead time for our custom pieces of about 6 to 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Of course, it doesn't take us that long, but they have a steel frame inside, and then a timber structure that the steel frame sits in. The legs get turned for each suitcase.
All right.
And then it goes to an upholsterer.
Okay.
So each piece is custom made for each suitcase. So
there's
only one of each. So, for example, each suitcase is a different size, so the legs have to be made for each suitcase.
To fit and to balance, to make sure the seat height
is the correct seat height.
Okay.
Even the steel frame and the timber frame needs to be made individually for each suitcase.
Katie, before we move on to the rest of the objects, you said you're self-proclaimed hoarder, lover of junk. What is it about, you know, old vintage items that attracted you?
I think it's the history of the pieces, the character, where they come from. When I see them, it just makes me wonder where they've been and the life that they've had.
I know what you mean.
Katie, I'm really curious about the objects you've bought. Please take us through them.
One of the products that we make are these fridge magnets.
I have to see that. Uh-huh. Wow.
So keyboards from old computers end up on landfills, and we rescue them by the dozens, hundreds of millions, and we make each keyboard into a set of fridge magnets.
That is so
and
clever.
In each jar is one fridge magnet. Yeah.
Yeah, so, and there's a clock sitting next to you there. What is that?
So on the same landfill, we find...
You love landfills. Do you live there?
Sorry, on the same landfill. That's my happy place. Is rummaging in the rubbish dump where people throw things away and rescuing what people throw away and seeing what functional things I can make them in.
Yeah, and you seem to be quite a lover of clocks and watches.
To be honest, I find that's what sells.
Ah. Really?
Yeah, it's interesting. And also everyone needs a clock in their homes.
And what is that made of, that clock that you have in your hand there?
This is the inside of a Have a closer look.
A computer. Is that like a motherboard?
That's it. A motherboard. Aha! I didn't even know the name.
Motherboard, darling.
I didn't even know the name.
Okay, that is so clever. And Varna also is going to bring us some, you know, different types of other clocks that you've made right there. Spectacular. Wow.
Upcycling. What an apt word to describe your clocks.
There we go. Yeah.
So how long would it take you, let's say, to put together a clock like that with a bicycle wheel?
These ones don't take long. Mm-hmm. I do have this brass. There's a brass piece on there, and that we have spun to fit each clock, and that has the mechanism inside that holds the battery.
Yeah.
And we can also do a lot of them custom-made. So, for example, if you have something of your own that's sentimental, so, for example, your grandmother's vintage suitcase that sits in the garage, or you're a cyclist and your first bicycle wheel, and the wheel is sitting there and you can't part with it, or something that's functional, or something that's sentimental, it's in your home, you can't part with it, we can make it into something for you.
All right.
And there's a beautiful picture frame here.
This is something a little bit quirky. I'm not sure if everybody is cup of tea, but for me, it's interesting because nobody will know what it was before.
What is it? That's what I was going to ask you.
Can you guess?
Something to do with tennis?
Let me see.
Yeah, because you can see the Dunlop on the back.
What is it?
I have no idea. Is it a flower?
We're trying to figure it out.
It used to press a tennis racket. So when tennis rackets used to be wood, before they were plastic, they used to walk. So it used to press a tennis racket.
Katie, where the hell did you find that? Somewhere.
I can find 20
in a landfill.
At least tomorrow.
That one time at band camp. Where do you find most of your junk?
We do garage clearance sales.
Oh, okay.
And in the recycling
box. Sorry, I just have this picture of you rummaging through
bins. I can't even imagine you in a landfill.
Really?
Ever.
I dressed up for this occasion.
Katie Thompson, thank you very, very much for teaching us about upcycling. We learned a whole new way of, you know, recreating, making vintage pieces last a little longer, right?
Yeah.
Absolutely fantastic. Congratulations, by the way,
on
all your success. Wonderful stuff. If you want to, you know, get your hands on any of these wonderful pieces, make sure that you visit Recreate in Cape Town. Mm-hmm. Katie Thompson right here in our loft. Let's move over to Jeannie in the kitchen and see how our lovely dinner is coming up.
Thank you, ladies. Now, just as much as what you girls might like hoarding and going through, you know, landfills and the rest, I love food. And here we are in the kitchen with Anda, and I have to tell you, I've got a huge confession to tell you. Out of anything in the world, my favorite thing ever to eat is a tomato sauce.
Well, what better than one that's homemade for you then, eh?
I'm so excited for this. This is really, really yummy.
Cool. So you can see the tomatoes have cooked down now quite a mm-hmm. bit. Now comes the umami part of this whole sauce.
Now, what exactly is umami?
Umami is the fifth taste. I mean, it's not salt, it's not bitter.
The fifth taste, the fifth element in your mouth.
Yeah, so it's, I guess, a mixture of all of those together. But, I mean, the Japanese describe it in the best way, that it's a pleasurable taste.
It's and a pleasurable, desirable taste.
So it comes from Japan. I mean, in Japan, they used to dry fish out and use the fish scales for flavoring, and it's quite a rich, very rich flavor. So here I've got today, we've got parmesan. The parmesan rind you'd usually chuck away. Today I'm using it in the sauce. You'll get that wonderful parmesan taste in the sauce. You can use anchovies. We do have anchovy oil at Woolies, but today I'll just be using just two anchovies.
So the umami is going to be a combination of a whole lot of different flavors that you throw in together.
Correct.
It's not one thing that you can throw in and say, I'm throwing in the umami bean or something.
No, it's okay. Not. It's a couple of things. So, I mean, with these porcini mushrooms as well, usually I do hydrate them in a bit of water, but today I'm just going to take maybe a hand, three of them or four of them, and just chuck them inside
there. And porcini's always a good idea. It's a lovely, nutty mushroom.
And earthy, very, very earthy. So, I mean, if you're not a fan of those, you can just hydrate them in water and just add a bit of the water in there. I'm going to add maybe two or three olives in there as well, which I will pip.
I actually do own an olive de-pipper. You know, you get them. What a great invention. But obviously, you're not using one today.
No, I won't.
You're more skilled in the kitchen. I need those little contraptions.
So I'll just add one or two here.
Okay, olive always does give a nice saltiness to the dish.
Yeah, it's got a lovely, lovely flavour. So that also, you might as well just let that cook for a little bit now. So now to finish the sauce off, as you've seen, I haven't added any sugar to this at all. The sugar comes from the tomatoes. Tomatoes are very, very rich and delicious. So all I'm going to do is, I'm going to add a touch of maple syrup.
Okay.
That's where the sweetness is going to come. But this
and
you add right,
as well.
You add this right at the end. So I'm just going to add a bit of a drop there. There you go. For a bit of acidity, I'm going to add our sherry vinegar as well there.
Okay. Why do you need the acidity? Aren't tomatoes,
The tomatoes are acidic, but these willies, the Italian ones, they are very, very sweet. So I just need a little bit of acidity just to kind of
give it a bit of a bite.
So. So all you do is just basically stir that, and you can let that simmer for a little bit longer, and your sauce is done. Only thing you need to finish it with is just a bit of basil. What I do is I tear some of the basil, and some of the basil leaves I just leave in whole, just for that visual of it.
Oh, delicious.
There's no tomato sauce without basil, so... Mm.
And this is the perfect smell of Italy for me. Whenever you think of Italy, I think of Italy, it smells like basil.
If you tear the basil, the flavor of it just comes out instantly. Mm. If you add it in whole, it's just there for the visual. So I'll just add a bit of basil in there. You can do it a bit more. Now, once your sauce is done, this is your homemade sauce. I mean, why not get a beautiful jar and put it in a beautiful jar and store it in the fridge and use it as you'd like? So
exactly. And of course, if you're cooking with us at home, remember all of our ingredients and recipes are available on our website, which is afternoonexpress.co.za. And trust me, you definitely want to put this one on your menu because it smells so scrumptious. Now, I know that throughout the day, I've been trying to blackmail Bonang to give me her shoes. After she tastes this, I definitely think I'm in good stead for a candidate, as a candidate, to get my hands on those heels. B, how are you?
Well, you're almost there, my darling. Stick around. Maybe by the end of the show, you might have them. Wait and see. But you are in for a treat. We are so excited to have our next performer in the loft. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure performing for you right now on SABC3, Simphiwe Dana with a brand new single, Chibok. Enjoy.
Drowning in the sun.
I just got goosebumps, my entire body.
I feel you.
Oh, you feel me, baby. Oh, amazing performance from Simphiwe Dana. Let us know what you thought of it on Twitter right now, at Afternoon Chat. Use our official hashtag, Afternoon Express. Don't go anywhere. It gets better and better and better. After the break, we pop into our indoor garden with Jeannie D. Don't move.
Welcome back to Afternoon Express on SABC3. Now, herbs are a fantastic addition to any meal, and they're really rich in medicinal properties too. Today, we are going to teach you how to create your own indoor herb garden. Now, whether you are a novice gardener, or if you don't have much of a green thumb, anybody can do it. And to show us how to create our own indoor herb garden is the fabulous Cheral Kennedy from Living Matter Landscape Design. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Now, what exactly goes into having your own indoor herb garden?
Well, you just need a couple of pots, a couple of herbs, and that's easy.
And where's the best place to keep it in the house?
Definitely a sunny spot. It needs to have direct sunlight. A place like an atrium like this or a kitchen windowsill is really good. Also, if you've got a wall that gets direct sunlight throughout the day, that's perfect.
It's such a good idea because you don't have to give up on your fresh herbs when winter comes rolling in, as long as you have, what, about 4 to 5 hours a day of
usually
sunlight?
Usually during 10 to, say, 10 to 2 should be fine. Anything after that is a bonus.
Okay, excellent. Vanna, you're going to help us today.
Absolutely,
as well.
Yeah, very excited.
Do you have green fingers?
My mother has green fingers, so let's see if it comes out today.
Right? Okay, great. Now, what is the best kind of soil to use when planting?
Okay, so the best type of soil for a herb would be something that keeps the moisture in it. So something that's got compost, organic type of materials in it. So something like this is much better than something like this. This is sand, and it literally will just drain the water through. Right. The organic material in this type of soil will hold the moisture in for the herbs.
That already looks like it's got a lot more nutrients in it.
Absolutely.
Now, you know when people talk about feeding your plants, is it feeding your soil and feeding the plants through the soil? What does that
you can do? You can do two types of fertilization. One through the actual soil content, like this, it's got organic materials in it. Or you can do fertilizer on top of that. And you get different types of fertilizer. You can get fish emulsion, you can get organic compost, as well as organic fertilizers.
Okay, now I don't have a herb garden at all at home. Take me from the first step. What do I need to get?
Okay, so you need to get a container. It needs to be something that's got a hole in the bottom or a few holes in the bottom.
Okay.
It's for drainage. You need to find a deck. If you're just going to use something like this, something decorative that you can put it in, that ends up looking really nice.
Great.
So the first thing that we're going to need to do is to put a liner in the bottom here to prevent the soil from going through your drainage holes and just leaching out. This
looks amazing. I mean, you don't even need an atrium in your home to have your own indoor garden.
Absolutely.
You can, I mean, put this by the kitchen sink.
That works very well on a windowsill.
Divine.
So the first thing you need to do is start with a piece of bittern. This is a porous piece of material that allows the water to go through, but doesn't allow any soil to go through.
So it won't make a mess.
Yes. So you put that down at the bottom of the pot. Then you need to put some drainage chips in. So if you can do your...
You can use any stones for that.
Yes. So the smaller the better, because you're obviously wanting to... There we go. Perfect. Just about a fifth of the pot. Actually, that might be a bit too many. So we'll just take a few out, and we can put some down at the bottom there of this part, so that when this one sits on top of it, it's not, the roots are not sitting in the water.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Then we top this up with some soil. So obviously we're wanting our good organic soil. Okay, so we're going to fill this one up.
And what are the best kinds of herbs to plant, do you think?
You can plant anything. The best is obviously the ones that you're going to be cooking with.
Okay. The ones that you use most. So what are the basics, like parsley, basil, coriander?
Okay, well, we've got oregano, we've got coriander, we've got chives, we've got rocket, basil. That's parsley.
That's parsley.
Okay, so our soil's in.
Okay, so what we're going to do then is, if you can hold that, you can put that one down for now.
All right.
Is you loosen up your herb from the original pot.
Why is it important to transfer from the original pot into your own one? Can't you just keep this in your kitchen?
I mean, is that a silly question? I'm just all in for into low maintenance, and I think I bought it like that, I'm going to keep it.
Well, better answer it.
It's in a horrible container, so you don't really want to put that container into the kitchen. You want to be able to put it into a nice one. And usually,
so don't be lazy. Make it look nice.
And usually they're also pot bound. You can see this one's roots already showing. So this one's ready to be planted out into a bigger pot.
Okay.
So what we're going to do here is we're just going to loosen the roots a little bit, just to give it a little bit of extra oomph for when it grows.
So you loosen it up just to have like extra space for the roots to go and to oxygenate Correct. It as well?
Correct. And then you basically push this in.
Okay.
And how often do you go for a manicure?
I was going to help you there, but I thought, nah, it's not going to happen.
Okay, so literally that's basically how, if it was a little bit lower with soil, you would top it up with some extra soil, but this one's actually quite fine like that.
Okay.
And then you put it into your little pot. And as you can see, what we've done over here is we've topped this off with some decorative pebbles. So we can literally just...
As easy as that?
Yeah, you can just top this up.
And now, I mean, are these seasonal? Will they last a while?
Herbs do you have a lifespan in your kitchen because of it not being directly outside in the natural environment. So you will end up seeing that some herbs will tend to colour a little bit, and they'll also need to be chopped on a regular basis to keep them going, to keep them to grow.
Yeah.
You can see here, this one here has got a little bit of a lighter colour.
Okay.
So this one is needing a little bit more light, whereas you can see these ones are really strong and dark green. And they're actually doing really well.
But I think the more you use them, like if that one comes off now, if we're going to use it,
Absolutely.
Then it obviously grows more and fresher. And,
Absolutely.
Oh, delicious. I've actually just thought of something. We're cooking Italian in the kitchen at the moment. And do we have fresh basil here?
We do, yes.
We're about to start the caprese salad. And I think that would be the perfect ingredient. Vanna, won't you be a gem? And go and take
that.
It through to the kitchen.
Thank you, ladies. Cheers.
Thanks, Vanna. And thank you so much to you, Cheryl, for sharing with us how to create a fantastic indoor herb garden. If you at home are building one, please share with us and let us see what it looks like on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. It's, of course, Afternoon Express, or on Twitter, Afternoon Chat, hashtag Afternoon Express. Now, let's have a look and see how that caprese salad has come along in the kitchen.
Yeah, so we can just put these beautiful coloured tomatoes now just around the salad ever so gently.
Very pretty salad.
Just to make the salad look just a little bit pretty. You can put those aside. You can actually just dress just with some more micro herbs there. The vine tomatoes, I'm just going to put one just on the side here just to make it look beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And then another one here at the back.
We it's could a tomato snip them. Party, huh?
We could snip them. That's enough, more than enough.
Oh, okay.
And then we can just take the rest of the cheese and I'll do that. So the salad is very rustic. You just got to make it up right there on the moment, as you can see.
Yeah, I was about to say, I have seen very different caprese salads.
This is a caprese, like which is a little bit tweaked up. So, as you know, Italians love olive oil, so I'm just going to dress the salad just with a little bit of olive oil. Just to
You can never
it
have
off.
Enough olive oil.
They can't. They love their olive oil. Okay. And then nothing is complete without just a crack of black pepper. And there you go. Your caprese with a twist is done.
Oh, it looks amazing. Ladies,
bring it over.
Delicious.
Absolutely incredible. But let me tell you, Anda was telling us just during the ad break that there are 230 different types of tomatoes.
There are more than 230.
How many do you think there are in the world? Hey?
I've got no idea, but just in Italy we've got a variety of just over 213.
Fantastic.
This looks incredible. But before we go, I'm going to help Jeannie dish up. B, what is next for you? Where we're going to catch you? What's in store for us in 2015 with you?
Well, I've got a very amazing project coming up. Can't talk about it yet, but when it happens, I wish I could spill, but not yet. But I'm very excited about it. And I think I'm just on a journey of, I don't know, perfecting my craft of acting, and hopefully it'll take me places. So yeah, and Club 808, that's also keeping me excited.
Fantastic.
And the hunger of this food now.
Well, dinner is served. Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you
to every single one of our guests. And thank you to you for watching. Don't forget that all the recipes and, of course, ingredients you can find on our website, www.afternoonexpress.co.za.
That's from us tonight, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Same time, same place. Happy eating.
We love
tonight.
You, South Africa.
Cheers.
Good night.
Tomorrow on Afternoon Express, we enjoy a delightful Italian feast with Abigail Donnelly. media personality Maps Mopanyane talks about his career and style. We chat with Bailey Schneider and DJ Sucks about their engagement. SAMA award-winning band Beatenberg perform live in the loft. And our resident vet Daniel pops in to show us how to properly groom our furry best friends.
Another feel-good production.
Join us next time for more fabulous fun inspired by First for Women on Afternoon Express. For an insurance quote, call 0861 11 1844 or SMS FIRST to 49267.